oddly enough, I think the very first thing that I made was a delay line. It's not exactly...
digital. A digital delay.
Oh, no, digital. Yeah. Absolutely digital.
But it wasn't the 1745, right?
No. I'm talking about prehistory here. I made a couple of things just as an experiment. This is because I liked audio stuff. And the company that I was working for, remember, I was working in a defense plant with access to all sorts of integrated circuits, and they had shift registers for the real-time spectrum analyzers. And these shift registers had 256 bits. Not kilobits, not kilobytes, not mega, not giga, not tera, just bits. And I built, using 256-bit shift registers, an audio delay line. The A to D technology at the time was pretty primitive, but actually it sounded really good. It was a monotonic converter.
What was the thought? What was the purpose of the delay line going to be?
What, you had to have a purpose?
There we go.
Where'd you come from?
Bronx.
The Bronx.
That explains everything.
So, but wait, now you're saying A to D, D to A. Explain how A to D and D to A is going
on. Well, if
you're going to
have a digital delay line with analog signals, you have to convert the analog to digital. You put it into the shift registers. You convert it back to analog again, and then you could hear the signal only, in this case, I think it turned out to be 1 or 2 milliseconds later. And you could see it on an oscilloscope, or you could create a sort of a fixed phasing effect. And as the chips got better and cheaper, of course, you could make them longer and longer and longer. And a few years after making this little experimental prototype at home, the chips became cheap enough and reliable enough, or almost reliable enough, to make a commercial product out of it.
And when did you realize that it had a musical application?
Pretty much right away, I would say. I think Steve. Now this is when
he had a recording studio.
Steve was still with us with the recording studio. He would play around with this stuff, and he was recording McKendree Spring at the time. They may have been one of the first bands to use any of our stuff. It became obvious that that delay lines had a lot of functions in recording. And as time went on, the first delay we built was the 1745, and then the 1745A, which used actually pretty reliable shift registers as opposed to the 1745. They would keep, let's just say their infant mortality lasted into middle age.
I mean, obviously, prior to this, people were using tape delays.
So the initial delay limit on a 1745 is...
200 milliseconds.
There you go.
Although you could get one a little cheaper by having it half populated and going up to 100 milliseconds.
Right.
That's for people who weren't record plant. But we were always pretty sanguine about doing well with these things because from the very beginning, real studios would buy them.
Yeah.
Right.
I remember hand delivering a 1745M to Electric Lady.
Yeah.
Like in a box, and I was just so pumped. Yeah.
Yeah.
I was like, what, 18, 17?
Wow.
Electric Lady needs this right now. Go right down, bring it. It was carried on the train.
Did you take cash for it?
No, I did not. They dealt with that. I was
you didn't?
Like, no.
That's
he still
happened.
Has it in his pocket.
Yeah.
Still got that $200. So, what would have been? Speaking of, what were we selling this stuff for back then?
What was it, about $4,000?
No.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, antihistamine money, to be sure.
Holy
200
cow.
Milliseconds, $4,000.
That's great.
Back when $4,000 was worth almost $4,000. Yeah.